Okay, coming to the second section. Okay, the first one is give reason of the following. First, cholera and typhoid are communicable diseases. Answer is on page number 91. Okay, so we will go to page number 91 to get the answer. Yeah, so page number 91. See here, disease such as cholera, typhoid and dysentery spread through contaminated food and water. Okay, right, first point. Second point, since it is spreading through contaminated food and water, it is a communicable disease. Okay, so cholera and typhoid are communicable diseases. Next one, a handkerchief must be used to cover our nose while sneezing. Okay, go to page number 90. Okay, page number 90. Here we are having the answer. The last line, the germs responsible. Next page. For these diseases are present in the nasal passage of the infected person. When that person sneezes or coughs, the germs are released into the air along with the mucus and saliva droplets. The germs infect another person who inhales this air. Therefore, a handkerchief must be used to cover the nose while sneezing. Right? Next. Maintaining community hygiene is important to lead a healthy life. And the answer is, community hygiene helps keep our environment or the surrounding clean, thereby preventing the spread of diseases. Therefore, maintaining community hygiene is important to lead a healthy life. Next, anemia cannot be spread from one person to another by shaking hands. Okay? Because anemia is caused due to the deficiency of iron and is a non-communicable disease. Okay, therefore anemia cannot be spread from one person to another by shaking hands. Next, vermicompost can help enriching the soil fertility. Page number 99. Okay. When earthworms are added into this heap, they speed up the decomposition of organic matter. This is called as composting. Sorry, this type of composting is called vermicompost. Okay. Vermicompost is an organic material which can be used as a fertilizer to enrich the soil and grow healthy plants in it. Okay, so in place of compost over here, you will be writing vermicompost. So these two points you will be including, right? So that is the answer for the next give reason, that is vermicompost can help enriching the soil fertility. Next, differentiate between the following based on the criteria given in the bracket. So whatever is given in the bracket, only that much you need to write. Nothing else has to be written. So first one is disease and health, page number 90. You have to just write the definition, because only definition is asked in the bracket. Okay, so you will go to page number 90. So here we are having health definition. Okay, and from health is defined as a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being of an individual. That is the health definition. And disease, a disease is a state in which the body or a part of it deviates from normal functioning and experiences discomfort. So, regarding the disease and health definitions, okay, first differentiate. Second one, germ and vector. Example you need to write, okay, for germ and vector. So, for germ, you can write virus, V-I-R-U-S, virus. And for vector, you can write mosquito. Okay, mosquito. Understanding? Next, deficiency diseases and metabolic diseases. Here you need to write the cause. What causes deficiency disease? What causes metabolic disease? Okay, so for that we will go to page number 95 and 96. Okay, so here on page number 95, the cause for the deficiency diseases is given. Okay, The disease is caused due to lack of one or more essential nutrients in the diet is deficiency disease. Okay, coming to the next one, that is metabolic disease. What is the cause? Diseases or disorder caused in the body due to the malfunctioning of the organ or organ system or by the imbalance of certain control and coordination mechanism are called metabolic diseases. So this is for metabolic disease. Causes that due to malfunctioning of an organ or the organ system or by imbalance of certain control and coordination mechanism, right? So that is the cause for the metabolic disease. The next one is goiter and rickets. Symptoms you need to write. So go to page number 96, okay, in the table goiter and rickets. Only the symptoms you need to write, okay. Goiter ka symptom likho and then you write the symptoms of the rickets. Only these two points you need to write, okay. One for goiter and one for rickets. Yeah. After that, chickenpox and cholera, causative agent. Chickenpox, causative agent is virus, and cholera, causative agent is bacteria. Right? Yeah. Next one is explain the following. First one is droplet infection. Page number 91. Okay? Yeah. Page number 91. So, here, when the person sneezes or coughs, the germs are released into the air along with the mucus and saliva droplets. Okay? So, that is called as droplet infection. Here. Okay? So, that is called as droplet infection. You can include the previous point also, but then that much is enough. Okay? Yeah. So, droplet infection. The next one is composting. Page number 99. Over here. Okay? You can just write the answer. Yeah, here. Over here. Due to the action of decomposers, the organic waste breaks down into simple nutrients and turns it into useful manure ready to be used in the garden for growing healthy plants. Okay? And this process is called as composting. Right? You write this complete thing and then at the last you write this process is called composting. Right? Yeah. Coming to the next question. Malnutrition. The answer is directly on page number 95. Okay. So, you are having over here the answer. Malnutrition over here. Okay. Just below the figure. Malnutrition is caused due to consumption of food that does not provide all the essential nutrients in our body in sufficient amounts on page number 95. Okay. Next question. Hereditary diseases. Page number 97. Okay. Here. Hereditary diseases, page number 97. Diseases that are inherited from parents are called as hereditary diseases. Next one, anemia, page number 96. Okay, see, anemia ka definition as such is not given. You need to write it from here. Okay, so anemia is caused due to deficiency of iron. Okay, and here you will be having symptoms like pale complexion, tiredness and weakness. This much is enough. Okay. Anemia is caused due to deficiency of iron and the person will be having pale complexion, tiredness and weakness. That's all. Fine. Next is short answer questions. Define communicable and non-communicable diseases. Okay. So, regarding communicable disease, you are having the answer on page number 90. We have, I think, already discussed about it. Okay. Page number 90. Communicable diseases. Diseases that can spread from one person to another are called communicable disease. Then go to page number 94. Diseases that do not spread from one person to another are called as non-communicable diseases. Okay. Next one. Why should food not be left uncovered? Page 91. Page 91. Okay. See here. Flies are the common carriers of germs. They sit on the garbage and fecal matter and carry germs on their body. When the same flies sit on our food, they transfer the germs onto the food, contaminating it. Therefore, food should not be left uncovered. Okay? Yeah. Next one, do vectors get infected with the disease of the germs they grow, they carry? No, the answer is no. What is the reason? Because they are just the carriers. Okay, they are just the carriers and the germs do not infect them. Okay, they are just the carriers and the germs do not infect them. Next one, how do landfills contaminate the environment? Page number 99. Here, okay, this complete thing. From landfills are shallow areas where waste is dumped in layers up to here, harmful air pollutants. Okay, all these things you will be including for the answer. Okay, because these things are required for the answer. Next one is, what are deficiency disease? Give two examples. Page number 95. Okay, deficiency diseases. Disease caused due to lack of one or more essential nutrients in the diet is known as deficiency diseases. And regarding the examples on the same page in the table, you get these two examples, kwashiorkor and marasmus. Okay, so you can write these two names itself, right? Yeah, so these were the short answers. Okay, long answers we will discuss later on, fine.